the fuck just happened?
Dude, you're fucking asking the wrong person. I have no idea.
What the fuck just happened, dude?
That was the dumbest cutscene in this game.
Wait, okay, so first of all, they can see her? I thought she was in my head. What the fuck?
No. They can't see her because she was talking through us, remember?
Yeah, I know, but they interacted with her.
How?
Like, they made her float into the thing, or did she do that on her own?
She did that.
I thought she was just like a projection kind of thing.
Mike, you're thinking too much into this. This game is not meant to be thought about. This game is just meant to be played.
I like the first 50% of it, but the last, particularly the ending here.
About the part where Lo Wang turned into a pussy?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm saying that as a joke, but I mean it in like all seriousness. He went from like a character that's a parody to a character that actually isn't a parody.
What the fuck, man? I mean, okay. The good parts of this game, I mean, combat was still pretty fun. The co-op was very tacked on. I guess Pat will attest to that. Co-op is just like, considering how it was like advertised as like a major part of the game, it was pretty garbage.
And look, I'm not complaining to be a bitch about it. I'm complaining because, I'm not even complaining, I'm just saying, I mean, it really was just, I had no control over anything. I had no map, and I had no map, I couldn't use any of the vendors, couldn't use the crafting shit, half my powers are broken.
Wait, I should mention that the half of those things that Pat listed is, they are glitches, so if you're watching this, like, a couple months after, maybe even right now, because I'm sure this is going to come up a
week after.
How long
has this game been out, Mike?
Less than a month now.
So it's been out long enough for several patches to already come out.
I mean, there was more critical issues when the game originally came out. I mean, I would think that maybe I'll try this game. I'll have another swing at it maybe like a year down the line, maybe when they patch the shit out of it. Maybe there's going to be some kind of
And the obligatory DLC comes out.
I mean, I don't think they had a DLC for the 2013 Shadow Warrior at all. I don't think they did that.
No, but they did DLC for Hard Reset.
Did they?
Yep.
Oh yeah, I remember they did that. Yeah. But regardless of all of that, I mean, it was still an okay game because it was, like I said, I'm still judging it based upon the fact it was $30. I think it's not exactly the game. Like, I don't think these co-op issues are gonna be fixed at all because it's not just about these bugs. It's also about the pacing of the game is stupid actually. The way they did it because they have this inventory system, right? And, like, whenever I wanted to go manage something with my inventory, like...
It takes forever.
Like, the funny part is, like, me and Pat here, we play a lot of ARPGs and things like that. What the fuck is... A network error occurred. How fitting.
Dude, we'll never even know if there's, like, something after the cutscene. Or yeah. after the fucking credits. Are you kidding me?
Where are the fucking credits? Why does it need to be... Oh my god.
Hold on, I gotta Google this. I wanna see if there's something after the credits.
Yeah, you look that up for me while I continue to finish my thought. Okay, me and Pat play a lot of really complicated
games that actually require thought.
Yeah, like we play, I don't know, like, we've played, like, Stellaris, he introduced me to RimWorld, we play Path of Exile together. These are really kind of complicated, they're not necessarily just, they're 4X games or RPG games and things like that. I have to say, in Shadow Warrior, there's way more inventory management and, like, having to focus on... Because you can't tell what's trash or not because the stats on everything is so random.
I'll even say this. The difference between even what it considers the highest tier items and the lowest tier items, like whites and yellows, there's no... Like, I found that some of the white items are flat out better than some of the yellow items.
Yeah. Yeah, I actually started using white items on some items because I'm just like, everything keeps lowering my damage. I just want damage. Like, they keep going like, oh, reload speed, but you get less damage. And like, why the fuck would you ever use that?
I know.
Oh, I want to reload
faster. No, the worst ones are, it's like for the sword damage, it's like decreased enemy elemental resistance, but 12% less damage to large enemies. Well, what the fuck? Well, great, that's fucking great. So, you're literally giving me absolutely nothing here. Because the small enemies aren't a problem. Why?
I don't know. I, as I said, I I think the biggest mishap of this entire game is the stupid inventory system.
Yeah.
I hate to say this, but this is the one thing Borderlands did pretty well, which is, like, the weapons differ in stats, and then you kind of, like, kind of glance over them and kind of equip one. And they definitely should have gone something with that. Not this stupid, because it's this stupid system where they have, like, these all these gems and stuff. It makes everything 3 times more complicated, times, like, 8, times, like, whatever, like, because you have 8 weapons and 3 slots, and then, like, oh, my fucking God, that was the work. I really hated that. So I would actually recommend if you liked what you saw, which, like I said, gameplay-wise, it's not that bad. There's still a lot of flexibility
just
with
don't
this.
Don't play it with any friends you want to keep.
Yeah, don't... are you saying something, Pat, here?
No, I'm not saying anything at all, Mike.
That was not... never heard from again. No, I would never play this in co-op. Honestly, I've always had this opinion where, like, co-op makes everything better. Like, it's kind of weird. Like, even, like, a game that you wouldn't think is necessarily suited for, like a horror game or something, it's still more fun in co-op because you get to experience it with a friend. I think that the mechanics in this game specifically agitate the person you're playing with. You know, because you're either, like, one of you is always running ahead, one of you is always, like, looking at your inventory. Just kind of meh in that regard. That's all I have to say for that. Don't play this in co-op, I would say.
I the biggest problem is, I think some of the biggest issues that for me as a co-op partner, for the co-op issues, is not stuff that's going to be fixed. Like, the issues with me going invincible sometimes, the issues with me dying repeatedly sometimes, just like that endless meat grinder, the issues with the buggy skills, all that can be thrown to the side. That'll be fixed in future patches. That can all be changed. That can all be fixed by the game developers if they give a shit. But there's stuff like, I can't use the crafting bitches, for example. Those orbs of Masamune, I cannot use those at all.
I mean, those, like, could
I'm
be
still
fixed.
They could be, but there's still issues with the game that aren't bugs that intentionally fuck up your co-op partner.
Yeah. As I said, it just feels like it's very much of an afterthought with the co-op stuff. I wasn't a big fan of that. And they really have to... they have to get rid of this stupid inventory system. It's so bad. Like, it prolonged the game so much, I would say. Because I think I spent, like, a good 20% of the time doing that. Like, managing inventory. I do like the fact that the game isn't as long. Because it actually... it ended right when I kind of wanted it to. Opposed to the first 2013 game where it went on for way too long. Story-wise, I'm actually going to mention something about the story. I think that they did too many cutscenes and too much story. They tried to make a story around it. And I think that wasn't, like, it's what I was saying earlier in this run, which is basically, like, I like Lil Wayne because he's basically Chinese Duke Nukem.
And, yeah.
I mean, we both agreed that we hated it when he turned into a giant pussy, but, I mean...
offended by us calling him a pussy, by the way. We're not calling him that to be offensive to pussies.
The character was funny.
Because he did a full 180 where he was just like this cynical asshole that just chopped people up and just thought it was the funniest shit in the world. And then all of a sudden, I guess because of the loss of all these people that hated him.
But it's like it turned into a completely different game because it was like a non-serious kind of like we run around and kill stuff and then he says some kind of like really lame joke. But that's part of the charm. That's the funny part, is that it's cringy in its own right in a lot of ways. And then he turned into, like, it was cringy but sappy and like, oh, now it's not funny anymore. It's just bad. Like, that's kind of what it turned into. And so, like, I like the whole kind of thing of, like, it's time to kick ass and chew bubblegum. You just go, like, for no reason there's a big monster there and you go just go kill him. Like, it doesn't need context. But they kept trying to add context to everything. And it was bad because of that. It doesn't, like, does he need a reason to kill something? It's just, it's a big enemy. Just fucking go kill it. Like, I felt it could have been way more on the side of, like, just...
humor?
Just fuck the story. Fuck the dialogue. You know, like, the cutscenes. Get rid of the cutscenes, you know. Like, make it all about, like, as I said, like, one-liners, and he just goes in there and does shit and whatever. And stuff like that. I mean, I like the fact that they turned the dialogue into that press E to C, because like press E to hear it, because if you play his game a lot, then like you don't really want to hear the dialogue every time. To be honest, I didn't really want to hear it at all after a certain point, but I was just doing it for you guys, but I don't know. By the way, we were playing on Who Wants Wang difficulty, and there's no pain, no gain difficulty. Oh, they have different insanity levels. Okay, so there is some replayability in here, in case you guys...
There is actually missions after the end game, by the way, but it's rehashes of what you've already done to get more skill points and those orbs of Masamune so that you can get new items. Or get different items.
Like, what do you mean rehashes? Like, what? How the fuck does that work?
It's the same missions as before.
Okay.
By the way, Mike, what did your damage resist end up being?
Zero.
God damn it.
I never did it.
You never got any damage resistance?
Nope. In fact, some of the weapons I'd equip would lower my damage resistance. I'd take more damage. Hell. I did, however, I did do, I did put sync points into HP. But that's all I did.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason
I got all the HP shit I could get.
So why were you asking me about that?
Because I'm looking at mine now, and this is something I wanted to mention, is I felt as a melee character in this game, I would die to shit for no fucking reason.
I can't really know. It's unfortunate you weren't, like, streaming or recording your own perspective or something, so I could look back on it and say, like, hey... I don't know if it's netcode or anything, because I can't see your perspective, but...
Right.
I have to say, though, I think that melee is very solid in this game.
I agree with that, but there were times, like, and it happened specifically in certain boss fights. Like, the robot... Not the robot fight, but the one with Amiona at the end. Yeah. I died in that instantly. And I don't know if she did this wind-up attack that I never saw, because I couldn't see it because I was up close or what. But I ended up at this game. I had all three of my armor slots with damage resistance, and this lowered my item drop chance, which didn't really matter. And then one life drain one. And I ended up having 67% damage resist. And I also had the skills, which one was it, under elemental shield, where my vulnerability to elemental effects is minus 100%. I had 172 life. And I just seemed to die.
I mean, I don't really know why that would happen, but I wasn't in things' faces. Like, I had speed plus 30%, resist 0%, and life 133. And by the way, I'm looking at this weapon damage thing now, and I kind of see how this works now. It goes light heavy, and I'm pretty sure heavy means rocket launches and things like that. So that one thing I got, that one, the marksman still I got in the, like, the beginning part of the game, yeah, never changed it out. No point, because I was planning on going guns the whole time, so...
But I used the same soul the whole time, the one that increased melee damage but lowered gun damage.
No, I know, yeah. But, sorry, anyways, back on your thought. I mean, I played in a way where I was constantly dodging and being evasive, but, like, I picked an engagement distance
that
was
optimal for
the gun.
When you got hit, how much damage did you take?
I mean, you can look in the video. It wasn't an incredible amount. I mean, but the thing is, I wasn't getting hit a lot. So, and, I mean, these one-hit attacks that you claim to be getting killed by, I mean... Enemies that looked pretty threatening, I would choose not to go near, you know?
I think there was a lot of, like for me, just a lot of, like, wind-up attacks that, you know, that always do a lot of damage that I just couldn't see.
That may have been the case. I can't tell you for sure. I mean, that's weird. I mean, you could try in single-player sometime and see if it's, like, the same deal, but whatever. Maybe it is a netcode thing. You never know.
I don't know. I'm not going to blame netcode in this, because it seemed to be pretty solid outside of the few issues that were your fault.
Missions that were my fault, huh?
Well, you know, issues with the netcode, I mean.
I don't know, maybe. But, yeah, like, using the pump-action shotgun, I had damage resist negative 21%, but, like, a huge amount of crits, lots of very accurate weapon and things like that. But, anyways, that's besides the point. I still had fun with the gunplay, despite the fact it was something just felt off of the aiming constantly. It's either a mouse issue or something else. I don't know what it is. It's just something about, like, maybe there's acceleration on or something. Like, I'll show you at the settings. Like, I just have sensitivity, and I kind of put it to something roughly what I was comfortable with. Maybe I'm just not, like, that good at FPS games right now. Who knows? Or completely, depending upon your opinion of me. But that's just how that went. I'm not going to bitch about that too much, because that was a very minor issue. I mean,
that's... When I played the gunplay, it seemed all right, except for the goddamn mischance shit. And that feeds back into the fucking
mischance is spread. I'm pretty sure it's spread.
I have no idea. All I know is that there were several times when I got that one-shot rocket launcher, and then I had a bunch of the mischance shit on it just because, you know, it gave me a bunch of damage.
Spread. It is spread, and the reason why you're missing is because I have the same issue. And it's basically like, I think the hitboxes are really tiny, and things are, for some reason, the weapons just, they have something odd about them that makes them difficult to aim. It also could be the fact that things move around a lot in this game as well. That's what I think your issue was. I had the same issue with it. But anything with like a scope was really bad. Like something happened with the
bows
feel like
were the worst.
Yeah, I feel like I don't know what it is, but the zooming in for this was really bad. The bows were pretty bad, in terms of the usable weapons. But overall it was fun. Regardless of all of that, it was fun if you just don't if you just like shotgun. The shotguns were the best thing.
I think the more you think about it, the worse it gets. So I think you need to just stop.
Yeah, pretty much.
Just enjoy the game for what it
was. It still was enjoyable, I will say. I will say though that the last 10% of the game was fucking awful. The boss fight, especially the last boss fight, that was terrible.
Dude, both the last two boss fights were just awful.
The robot guy was the robot's.
I literally
better.
Just sat there and attacked his foot the entire time, and he died.
I think that's the problem with you being Malay. I was actually shooting him. I mean, the thing is though, like. I mean, not a lot of thought was put into that, because I'm guessing they didn't think that you'd play exclusively melee. I think they thought you'd go into a couple of guns, because you technically still do full damage with guns. Like, there's nothing stopping you from doing that. I mean, there's nothing stopping me from doing
that.
No,
you know what's fucking stopping me from doing that? No, what? This amulet that I'm using that makes my melee damage plus 30%, light firearm damage, and heavy firearm damage minus 20%. I ain't doing shit damage with guns.
No, but you still do some damage. You still do some damage.
It's literally shit damage.
As I said, you still could have had a turret. There's nothing stopping you from having that. But because of the emphasis on melee, they definitely could have done something better for melee. Like, you climb up onto them, like, stab them in the face a little bit, you know?
So quick time event, that's what you're asking
no,
for.
Not quick time. I'm like, you can actually climb the enemies rather than what you were doing, which is, like, because they run around a lot, that you can't climb them. Like, why couldn't you climb the robot and, like stab them in the weak spot or something? Like, there could have been a lot more thought that went into that, you know? But there kind of wasn't. It was just like, it was, I think, still primarily designed as a shoot 'em up game. The melee stuff just kind of carried over from Shadow Warrior 2013. But I don't remember how the boss fights went in that game at all. But it was...
I played that not long ago, like, when I say not long ago, I mean like 2 years ago. And the melee in that was actually really fucking solid. Like, compared to this, it's actually a really big difference.
Yeah, as I said, I think it was just a carryover from that, you know. Why the hell is that thing moving positions? Sorry, I'm in like a single player game. Okay, it just ignored me. Yeah, I guess we'll agree on that. What was the last thing I was going to say? Oh yeah, so the other things that I really liked about this game, animations were still top notch. I mean, there was some things I think that were more an engine issue where I saw things constantly clipping through in themselves, and things like the Queen of Pain, she had those little like strings coming down from her hat.
You said something about the animations in this game being good. I think you're fucking retarded.
No, they are. Well, at least for the first person things, like I like
the gun animations. Hold on, the gun animations. I'll give you that. The gun animations, the sword twirling, the reload animations. They're all fun. They're all interesting. They're all neat. This may be just me being the fucking co-op partner and, you know, getting shit on. Smith's face was terrifying. His eyeballs would freak out. His whole face would freak out.
That's
like,
more
his arms would jiggle, like, independent of his body. It was creepy.
Larry's
hair would stand up and start spinning around. For me, I know you had to see some of this shit because I saw you giggle at him a couple of times. Like, these characters had some of the shittiest, jankiest models, and it's fucking great.
I mean,
so
maybe...
don't say they had good animation.
That's a different thing from animation. It's more of the models, maybe. I don't know. You know, maybe it wasn't the same guy working on it all the time. It's hard to tell if it's... because I don't think it was just all one person. I think maybe the guy that did the stuff with the guns had, like, a fucking... a good time with it, you know, and decide to do some shit with that. As I said, I can't really tell you, but I will say it was. I've never seen a game with that much charm with regards to at least its weapon reloading animations. That was the best part by far, and apparently I can stand to this. I'm trying to think. There's one more thing I think I liked about the level design was kind of meh, because I don't like the fact they just had these big levels where you had to traverse it. I thought that was because everything looked familiar sometimes. And it is really janky. I did not like that too much. But I guess it adds a lot for replayability.
I'm going to say this, and this isn't a problem with this game specifically, but I think it's a problem with the gaming as a whole these days.
Yeah.
I think procedural generation's being overused.
I mean, I think it's maybe, especially if you play the game over and over again, Borderlands had no procedural generation, and I think this is better off. Well, Borderlands had some
This game, it seemed okay. It didn't have it like as bad as games like, let's say, Path of Exile or like Spore or Rimworld or like that kind of just constant generation. But with this, it just felt like we were just always just somewhere fucking random, and the whole entirety of the world. We never paid any attention to where the fuck we're at. We just dashed to the objectives and killed the shit we were supposed to.
Yeah,
the
actually,
world had been the most beautiful thing ever. There was nothing that we specifically looked at and were like, wow, that's neat. I'm going to stop and look at that. That looks nice. That's kind of cool.
The dashing was actually pretty stupid. I'm going to be honest, because I kept dashing everywhere.
Yeah, you never walk anywhere. You just dash.
Yeah. Oh.
I don't know, dude.
Yeah, that one was kind of meh.
I think, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, if this game had a specific setup world, like you had like your hub world, and from there you could travel to everywhere else, even if it was like through waypoints and shit, but a world that you had a general starting point and general specific like places to go. Like, remember when we saw that portal in like three different areas? And it was the same portal, the same fucking little thing, then we had to do the same thing each time, but in different locations. I think if we had done something like that, but it was a specific instanced area, something like handcrafted, like this is the world, the game would have been significantly better for it.
Maybe. I think they're thinking more about replayability, though, when they come up with this shit, so. But as I said, overall, it wasn't that good for that. I mean, as I said, the game overall, it's okay. I think it was worth the price overall, and that's the important part. Is it's worth the price?
Okay, I'll say that.
Because as I said, if I paid $60, probably not. We didn't pay $60; we paid half that, so we got half a game. If you want to say, I would say it's half a game. It's still pretty good in its own right. I mean, it's entertaining enough, but I would not play this with another person. Although I brought that into this.
Don't buy it on GOG.
Oh yeah, that's the thing I was going to talk about, GOG. I don't know if the network connection errors are a result of GOG Galaxy.
Connecting
or
to GOG Galaxy.
Okay, listen,
hold on. I looked this up on Steam when I was trying to figure out all the other issues. Out of all of the complaints that people had, there was no problems with the netcode, no problems with connecting shit, no connecting to the Steam servers. Because that is the actual message for the Steam people. I never saw a message saying connecting to Steam servers.
I mean, okay, listen, first of all, I never got that same message, and by the way, the message he's referring to only happened.
You did get that message.
Well, okay,
don't fucking say that.
I got it
message.
Once. You got it consistently. You got it like all the time, but I only got it one time.
Okay.
And that was probably, let's just say it was like either my internet fucked up or maybe they had downtime. Who the fuck even knows? But I only saw it ever one time. I think it is dependent upon the service you're using. So GOG Galaxy is the equivalent of Steam's servers, kind of a thing. Now, I will tell you why I got the GOG version instead of the Steam one. It's because I do like the idea of GOG a lot better. Steam is okay. Steam is fun, but you have to remember that Steam had, like, I don't know if you remember the heyday of like Half-Life 2 and when Steam originally came out, but Steam was a piece of shit. Everybody hated it. It took years for Steam to become like the force it is today, you know?
True.
So you gotta, I give them
so
a chance.
So you're supporting them in the hopes that they will be the next Steam?
Yeah, because to be honest, I like first of all, it's two things. It fosters competition. And before you say, why don't you support fucking Origin or whatever? Well, because EA is a piece of shit. And honestly, Origin's kind of crap anyways. But like, I like CD Projekt, and I like, because CD Projekt are the people who do GOG. And I like Valve, because they're both kind of like, they're not really like stingy on money all the time. They're actually pretty good. They're always like, hey, let's give a good deal to people kind of thing and make the experience better, you know, make a bit of money on the side. Not just like, how much can we charge and get away with it kind of thing. So like, I mean, GOG has this thing where they do GOG Connect, which is, it connects to your Steam account in certain games where the developers say yes. You will get that game on GOG as well as on Steam. Well, you have it on Steam already, but you can connect your two accounts basically. And that, I like things like that. And I think, you know, them competing against each other would be a great thing. EA just put their shit on Origin and then like just said, okay, you can't get it on Steam anymore because we said so. It's because they want a larger cut of the money. That's what they want. Because I'm pretty sure they give like something like 10% or something to Steam whenever they put it on that store. And so they want to make their own store so they can keep 100%. So it's all about the money for them. But for GOG, it's more like, hey, you know, DRM free. And I like that because that's like, you know, I've had issues with, this is back in the heyday when like offline mode did not work for Steam and things like that. And like sometimes even then, like you'll occasionally get like, it's like the DRM is kind of meh, but you know, DRM free, you can kind of stand by that, you know, you can do whatever you want with the games you buy kind of thing. Well, maybe not anything, but you get the idea. It's like, there's no kind of like copy protection involved in any of this. And the things like GOG Galaxy only exist to basically make it so you can have a multiplayer platform. That was their goal. And so, as I said, I'm willing to pick up an early adopter to see them like make that better, you know?
Well, Mike, you know, all I can think of is that you're a fucking hipster.
I'm a hipster. I sometimes like getting behind things that are early on just because... You know, I as I said, I like the ideas of things sometimes, you know, so that's pretty much all there is for that, you know. I don't know. I don't think it was a bad thing, but the implementation for this game was just not too good. I think most of the problems you had were with the fact you live in the middle buttfuck nowhere. You have problems with all kinds of things with the internet, Pat. Don't even get me started.
Bullshit. I never have issues with the internet.
What is your ping? Like, what is your ping when you connect to me? It's like 100, but you practically live, like, just a little bit south of me, and it makes no sense why that
a
would
little
be the case.
Bit. Dude. There's, like, I don't know. What is it, like, 600 miles?
Yeah, that for internet terms, that's, like, nothing. It's because you live in...
Yeah, that's your fault. No, don't say that. Don't blame me. Dude. On Dota, I have 16 fucking ping, okay?
It's because you live next door to the servers, I think, or something. I don't know.
Yeah, then how's that my fault?
I don't know. Something is your fault. You always had some kind of connectivity issues or something. I forgot what it was, where you had, like, an enormous ping. So it's hard to really say. But anyways, I think we've talked long enough. Do you have any other...
No, we bullshitted, I think, plenty.
Not bullshit. I just had a lot of thoughts, but I was saving for the end. But are we done now? You wanna
yeah, pretty much. The only thing I've got to say is don't play this with somebody you like.
Well, that's why I played it with you, Pat.
Exactly.
Oh man.
Go play a good game like RimWorld or Dwarf Fortress.
Or
Mike, if you want to get behind something interesting, go play Charles Barkley Shut Up and Jam Guide 2, brought to you by Shift4RD.
All right, guys. See you later, everyone. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. I mean, we had fun, so. Despite
I shield for Chef 4 RD.
Yes, you do. Alright, see you guys.